Alright, hopefully this everything's going to be working. Alright, so... Alright, let's get our butts down here. Make sure there are no zombies. I already had to kill one screamer today. I think the stream is up and running at this point. Go ahead and take you out. Actually, you know what? We're gonna do... Let's go ahead and make one of these. Actually, let's make a couple of these. What we're going to do is we're going to place a few of these outside here so that we'll be able to have a few places to drop loot. Ah, it's a screamer. Crap. Mister. Not twice. Was not expecting that. Alright. Where's she go? There she is. Ah, look. And that right there would be a reason why I'm putting down chests so I can do looting. Alright, so let's go ahead and drop some of this miscellaneous crap off. I've been picking up all sorts of stuff this morning. Hey Red, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. Happy Monday. We're gonna throw some of this extra crap over here just to get it out of the inventory. We have already repositioned the guns. Basically, all I did was set up the nerd pole basically to get to it, and then when I accessed it, I just turned the turrets inside. So they're now all facing inwards. So what they'll do is if anything gets into the wire here, that last round. Basically, they will have to deal with, the turrets will deal with them, so. Making it a little bit easier. Oh, it's been a long weekend. Alright. So, we have not started the clean, well, we've done a little bit of the cleanup operation, but not much. So what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and start looting some of this stuff up from the Day 35 horde. Because we got a lot of zombies to clean. I mean, it is crazy amounts of zombies on that. A lot of fun, but and this is why we went ahead and dropped a couple of chests out here so that we can pick all this stuff up. Need to keep it convenient so that, you know, you can come back and get your loot without having to worry about losing it from despawns and stuff. Oh, no worries. I'm actually doing pretty good. Like I said, the weekend was a little bit longer than I was expecting, but I've got a little bit of stuff done in one of the other games, so get to see some of that today over on the YouTube channel, and a little bit tomorrow morning, specifically for the Space Engineer stuff. Was doing a lot of behind the scenes for that. But yeah, can't complain. How about you? Did you have a good weekend? I think that's most of the stuff over here. Let's go ahead and drop all of this. There we go. We got all these corpses. So this was all from the Day 35 horde. I had one or two show up since then. Mostly screamers, but there was a couple of miscellaneous zombies as well. I do think what I'm going to do is I think I'm going to set up another turret out here. And what that'll do is it'll basically be the anti-screamer turrets. And I'll have it set up so that basically it's on a separate system, so I can leave a small generator running somewhere, and that way I don't have to worry about the screamers sneaking up behind me today. Because I just have this feeling that I'm gonna have another screamer show up here in a moment. 8 hour stream. Very nice. I've only done one of those. Those things are a lot of work. So congrats on getting your first one done. Of course, you say that like you're planning on doing more of those. So have you broken 500 followers yet? Or are you still working on that? Because if you did an 8 hour stream, I'm guessing you got a bunch of people following now. If so, congratulations. If not, don't worry, you'll get there. For those who are watching this later or have snuck in, first off, happy, well, whatever day it happens to be when you're watching the video. For the people who are here live, happy Monday or Tuesday if it's already Tuesday for you. But for those who don't know, Redaboo is actually another streamer. She's been a part of the community for a while now and recently started doing things on Twitch. So if you haven't checked her out already, I don't have my other bot running, so I can't do the quick shout outs, I don't think. I'm gonna have to set that up. But yeah, definitely go follow her. She's going to be at twitch.tv/reddabu, all one word. She's a lot of fun to hang out with, so. Alright. Ah. So much cleanup to do. Right. Hey, look, there's a screamer again. Ah. Can't tell if I hit her or not. I don't think I did. I need to wait. There she is. There she goes. Alright. May do another one, but not anytime soon. Yeah, I know. You get people like, you know, some of the bigger YouTubers who do Twitch every once in a while, like Markiplier and that crew. And some of those guys, man. It's crazy how they'll do like 24-hour streams. Yeah, I think the last time I did an extended stream that was more than like 4 or 5 hours, it was for a charity event. So, that's... Because those things, that, it's just, it's so much... It just takes so much out of you to do, you know, 6, 7, 8 hours of live streaming. So, congrats, though. No worries, Red. I used to work retail, and I've done service jobs and stuff, and yeah. No, jobs are great as long as, you know, one for all the customers. All right, let's grab a few of these. So, yeah, basically today what we're going to do is we're going to keep doing the cleanup. We're going to go over to the big build area, and we're going to do a little bit of building today, hopefully. I need to pick up, need to check to make sure I didn't leave all of my supplies over here last time. Wow, they've been tearing through this. Okay. And one of the things that I would like to do, if we have time, is maybe go on a little bit of a tour. Because I've got a couple of areas that I was thinking about maybe throwing down the new base. Because for those who haven't been following the channel, basically what I've been talking about doing is going out, grabbing some new areas to build a base off of the zombie highway that we have right here. Because what happened was, is in Alpha 16, the changes to the way that the zombies spawn... Oh, itchy nose. Has brought in a lot of new things, because with the sleeper zombies specifically, what we start running into is that we get the just hordes of zombies. So not only do you get the random hordes, you get the heat hordes, you also get sleepers, and now we've gotten to the point where most of our hordes that are spawning are actually feral zombies of different types. And that's, yeah, getting really, really annoying because the ferals always run. They take a little bit more damage than normal zombies. Check to make sure we don't have any corpses over here. And I thought I saw somebody wandering over that way. Well, I guess not. So having a build right here is great for the zombie kills. Ah, crap. But it's horrible for getting anything done. Because you spend all your time killing zombies. I mean, we're what? Just about 2,200 kills. We're only in day 36. Yeah. So, like I said, it's been fun. But I would like to have something that's a little less stressful right now. Something that I don't have to spend, you know, 4 in-game days doing nothing but zombie thinning. Just in time to do the 7-day horde. Would be nice if we got the real suppression mechanic back. Oh, no worries, Red. You definitely deserve it. Alright, so let's go drop this stuff off. Like I said, you can tell we had a crap ton of zombies just by the number of things that I'm dropping off here. I mean, look at that. Really? See, this is what I was talking about, the zombie highway over here. Alright, let's finish cleaning this mess up. So yeah, but I'm planning on this being a fairly relaxing day. I'm not foreseeing anything like large roaming hordes of death and destruction. Hello. Let's see. I don't have any furnaces running. I don't have any other things going on. But I'm getting a crap ton of screamers. For no reason other than the fact that I'm sitting here in the middle of a POI now. This is definitely one of the changes that Mad Mole made that I am not a fan of. It's just, you know, be nice to get stuff done here. Hey Red, thanks for the host. I appreciate that. Alright. So, do we have any more bodies over here to clean up? I know I've been killing some zombies. They've been dying on the spikes, so shouldn't have to do too much with it. Okay. So I think that is all of the general mess. So what we're going to do is let's go ahead and start cleaning out the chest, pull all the useful stuff out. We'll leave the crap in here. I'm not really worried about some of this stuff. Actually, you know what? Let's go ahead and empty all this out again. Because I want to grab all the useful stuff. We're going to leave that. Are you actually worth anything? Oh, you are worth something. Okay. And those definitely. You are scrap metal. You are also scrap metal. As are you. Okay. So we want the nails. Let's see, what do we want? You know, that's one round, I'm not going to worry about one bullet. You, however, are scrap metal as well. So not too bad. Okay, so let's go take this stuff over here. Do a little bit more triage on our looting. Nothing in there. That would have been bad. Might have been funny, but that would have been bad. Okay. Alright. So some of that stuff is what we're going to take with us. Hey, look. Another screamer. Okay, we've been streaming all of like 10 minutes, and I'm getting basically one streamer every 3 minutes here. Where are you at? There you go. Aw, crap. She spawned the horde. So that's either, she either spawned a horde, or we just happened to get a random roaming horde at the same time as with screamers. Sheesh. And we got a biker behind us. Sheesh. Look at them all. And then after killing all these zombies, we're going to have to deal with another screamer because of the heat map generation. Because we just fired off a crap ton of bullets. Scrap that. Not worried about you. Go ahead and drink this. Alright. For the folks that are joining us, we are on day 36. Just doing a little bit of cleanup. Having some fun. You know, we've been streaming now for coming up on 20 minutes, and we have seen a ridiculous number of zombies and screamers already. So it tells me it's going to be a busy, busy day. Missed him. My finger's a little tense there. There we go. You are empty. You are not empty, but that's okay. So, can we now get stuff done, please, Mr. Zombies? Alright. So the last time I was over here, I opened up the chest, looked over, and there was screamers. So apparently, now I've been told that opening and closing chests will add to the heat map, and like ridiculously adds to the heat map. Now I don't know how true that is, but given the fact that everything that we've done seems to be generating zombies, I'm starting to believe it. Alright. And yeah, red, they usually are. So what I'm thinking I am going to do is, I don't know if I'll do it today. I might do it today, I don't know. It's a bit of extra work to do, but what I may end up doing is rerunning the wiring system for the turrets. Basically have a second line coming out of the generator feeding, well actually I'll just feed it to here and then have a switch over here that turn the gunnery towers on and off by themselves and just run the line up. But so we'll see. Right, so we have a bunch of crafting stuff that's going to go in there. Go ahead and get our food stuff sorted out. Hey Brian, how you doing? Welcome to the stream, buddy. Hope you're having a fantastic day. I am actually having a lot of fun today. Been a little busy so far this morning. And for those who are asking before you ask, yes, there is fan in the background. It is bloody warm here today. Bay Area is going through some weird heat situation. Basically, it's getting up into the 80s every day, and then later in the day, it cools down again, so it's rather annoying, actually. Makes it very difficult to get stuff done. Alright, so we got that going, got this going. We've got one schematic, you are for sale. We're gonna drop all of our schematics over here now. We'll take 13 of you, why not? Alright, so do you have anything cooking? No. 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 Okay. That was a lot of iron. Okay. Let's see here. Don't need any of that. We do want that, though. Bring some cobble with us. Bring this stuff with us. We do have a couple extra turrets and some blade traps. I could start setting up more stuff. I don't know. We'll leave it like it is. It's fine. And so I've been slowly collecting the solar stuff. I'm not sure if it's worth doing, but it'll be interesting to see, because apparently it's the solar isn't supposed to add a whole lot of heat to the heat map. Alright. So we'll go up here. Come on. Oh, okay, so let's head over to the other base. We'll take the mini bike over. We don't have to go across the surface now because we've got the tunnel connecting them, but it's a little more entertaining to go this way. So we'll do this. Besides, my battery could use a little charging. So what we'll do is we'll take the battery in and throw it. And do I have a battery bank over here? I don't know if I do, actually. But I wanted to get things over here upgraded. A little bit, at least. And we're gonna park ourselves just like that. Because we can. Alright. Thought I heard zombies there for a second. I'm like, whoop. Let's close that down for a moment. Okay. Go ahead and refuel you. We're gonna drop fuel here so that it's out of the way. We'll drop some shotgun shells over here too. Drop some arrows. I think that is probably everything we really need out of there. Come here. Thank you. There we go. So we're going to be a little busy today. Okay, so I'm going to grab that stack. Grab that stack. Grab that stack. We're going to set this up. How many of these can I make? Oh, crap. We can make a bunch of those. Oh, what do I got? I've got 272. There we go. I was going to put a campfire over here, but... Oh, you know what? I have a bunch of sand and crap I was going to bring over with me so I could get more cement cooking. Alright, so we are going to go back to the other base really quick. Sorry about that. What I should do is widen this up and put a mini bike down here. I may do that, actually. I'll do that off camera, because that's just going to be basically 20 minutes of me with an auger, so. So, for the folks who are joining us, we are on day 36. We're just kind of hanging out today, getting some stuff done, running around back and forth between bases. I'm starting to think that I probably should have just gone ahead and jumped on the mini bike and rode back. The reason I didn't is because it's a little bit faster to do it this way. But I do think I'm going to put a mini bike down here. Basically open this up a little bit. And up we go. Yay, elevators. Okay. Alright, so I wanted to bring... the sand with us. Okay, so I already took all the stone over. Make sure I got everything this time. Take the auger with us. I'm gonna start upgrading these things. Not that it really matters. The quality of these don't really do anything for you. But I think that's everything. Oh, you know what I haven't done? I didn't reload my bloody UI. Alright. How am I doing for food? We're good for food, but we're out of water. Okay, so we're gonna go ahead and drink. Since we are here, let's go ahead and drink a couple of these. Just go ahead and, you know, basically reload ourselves here. Down we go. Oop. Alright. So now we'll head back to the other base really quick. I just realized I'm carrying the Molotovs with me too. Doesn't that figure? Alright. So it looks like we got some zombies spawning upstairs. Alright, so what we're going to do is now that we have our supplies with us, we're going to start crafting more cement. We're gonna start working on the world building here. Yeah, and I think that's pretty much what we're gonna be doing today. We might go do a little bit of exploration or something. I don't know. We'll figure it out. Like I said, today's more about relaxing than anything else. No, that's right. I was heading right. That's right. I haven't moved my crafting stuff down here yet, so at some point I'm going to be moving my crafting stations all the way downstairs. But I've got this weird issue that because I've got land claim blocks, they're not overlapping each other's fields. So every time I drop a new one, it breaks the old one. So I have to take the old one out and replace it. Really annoying. So we're gonna let's go ahead and drop all this over here for right now. All right, so how much of this do we need? That's an hour's worth. That's pretty good, actually. Minutes. Hello? Hello, computer. Come on. Thank you. Alright. So what we're going to do is we're going to grab one of these. We're going to split this down into those. Get all of our cement up and running again. Actually, you know what I forgot to do? I forgot to do that. All right, we'll grab another stack of this. Grab that. Turn you on. And we'll go ahead and do this. Alright, let's start breaking this stuff down just a little bit. Just try to get as much of this done today as possible. Okay, so we've got that running. We need. How much of this do we have? Drop this stuff off really quick. Let's sort this out so we can see. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's drop the partial stack. That's going to be 6. So we're going to grab 2 of those. 2, 3, 4, 5. Alright. Drop that off there really quick. 5 and 6. So grab those. And that should be enough for us to do quite a bit. So we can do what? Like 12k? Yeah, so we're going to do 9 and 9. 1, 2, 3, 4. Do the same over here. Alright, and that leaves us a little bit. Okay, so let's go ahead and drop this stuff off. Drop that stuff off. Yeah. Ah! No. Where'd he go? Where'd you throw it? There it is. That's way too much stone to not keep a hold of. There we go. Alright. And then we'll just drop all that off. Pick our stuff back up. If my computer will catch up to us. Alright. We're gonna grab pretty much all of this. I'm not sure why it's so chunky today. Let's see. Come on. Yeah, my mouse has been acting up lately, and I'm not sure why. I know it's not the batteries. I think it's just too much going on here. We might have a little bit too much RF in the area again. So. Alright. So we're going to go this way. Come on, up we go. Thank you. Make sure we don't have anybody lurking around here. Right. Okay, so. Okay, this song is just irritating me here. Hold on a second. See if this one's any better. That might be a little bit better. Okay. Let's not have that on the hotbar. 1, 2, 3. And so this is basically what we're going to be doing here is finishing this stuff. We're going to go ahead and put all of our markers down. I could swear I hear zombies. All right, computer. Thank you. Come here. My system's a little tired, I think. I haven't rebooted it in a few days, so. And after you play 7 Days to Die for a bit, you have a tend to have an issue because of the memory. Between this and Space Engineers. You know. Just it ends up losing a little bit of RAM, it's fine. And so basically all we're doing is we're just tying this back into the superstructure. So that we end up with something a little bit more secure, hopefully. We'll see if it actually works. I mean, we have a bit more to get done with the base, obviously. Come on. Come on, computer. Thank you. I apologize if it's getting a little chunky on your side. probably should have restarted my system earlier. We'll see. We'll see how it goes. Let me know if it gets a little unbearable for you. Are you actually... Yeah, whatever. Come on. I'm wondering... Oh, come on. This is starting to get a little unplayable. Get some stuff done. Really? So for the folks that are wondering what I am building, I'm building basically a giant pyramid. It's a build that's loosely designed around or influenced by the Transamerica building in San Francisco. If you have never seen this building, it is basically the San Francisco Pyramid. Now, I did, after I got the initial build stuff laid out, built my central column, that was how tall it was going to be. We ran into a problem because I can't get the slopes in the game to basically give me a grade that I want. I need them to be a little bit more vertical. So if I wanted to build that big, what I needed to do is actually make these walls bigger. They needed to be, they need to go further out. So as it is, we're only going to make it about maybe halfway, two-thirds up the way the, up that, yeah, about halfway up. But that's okay. We don't mind. It's fine. We'll make it work. So now that we have this done, alright, so let's go ahead and get this stuff upgraded. Alright. So anybody have any questions, any concerns, feedback? What do you think about the build? Like it, don't like it, don't care? So, get this done. One of the things about Alpha 16 I like is that they've changed the structural integrity, so it's a little simpler now than it used to be. Now there's just, you hit a certain level and it's done. You know, structural integrity just does not like you after a certain point. Which I'm fine with. Can I get you... Yes. Alright. Bit more of this done. And basically what we're going to do is the same thing that we did over on this wall where we took it up there. I'm just trying to get this, the wall we're currently working on, or the side we're currently working on, caught up to it. And then we'll start working on the rest of it. But I want to get at least two of the walls done as much as possible. That way you can see it on camera, and then I'll end up doing a lot more of it off camera. It's definitely a big build, Red. But I'm glad you're liking it. What I'll probably end up doing is this week. So for 7 Days to Die, for videos this week, we're just going to be doing the live stream today. I will have a recorded 7 Days to Die video for Wednesday over on the YouTube side of the house. I may upload it here as well, just so that it's convenient for the folks that don't necessarily hang out on YouTube now. So if you're already on Twitch, you know, we'll have a VOD over here or something like that. We'll see how it works out. I haven't really done a whole lot with the VOD system in on Twitch, but, you know. I have been told it works nicely. So I think I'm going to need to set up stuff over here. So that I can get some of this other stuff done. So I don't want to have to keep going back over here and dropping down. So I'm thinking, let's make some ladders. I don't know, we'll make like 30 ladders just to get them in there. What we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and drop down here again. And we'll finish upgrading that. Oh, that would have been bad. Come here. Alright. What we'll do here is we're going to grab these. We're going to go... like so. That gets us back up. Okay. So, when we're ready to go down, all we have to do is basically go this way. Alright. You know what? I'm gonna have to move that. Because I need to take that out right there. Ah, crap. Well, that wasn't very well thought out, pal. No, we might be. You know what? Let's do this. And then what we'll do is we'll just tie it to this chain here. Because it's going to be all in here anyway. Like, we're going to be reinforcing all of this. And then we should be able to pull that one out. What we're going to do is we're going to bring this around this way to give it a little bit extra hook, and hopefully it works. And doesn't come crashing down and kill us all, right? Okay, so we actually have a platform over here now that we can get up and down. See? Alright, so what we're going to do is let's go ahead and get the rest of these in, and then we won't worry about coming back through here until we've gotten everything else done. Alright, so we're going to go over here now, go over this way. Can I get... this? Because now if we do it this way, we can just go ahead and say... like so. Like so. See? Nice and easy, right? And come on. There we go. Tie that together. And the nice thing is we can take stuff like this and we can just say like this, just get it in here. That. That would be our turret defending our base. So we're getting closer to getting to the middle. I mean, we've only got a couple of more tiers to go here. Oh, all right. So, this gets us most of the way there now. Now, I do need to go like so. So what I'm doing is I'm marking basically where the columns are that continue up, so that we'll be able to build in more support if we need to. 2, 3, 4, and 5. Okay, that's good. So now that we have that, we know that those are going to be here. We're going to go ahead and match rotation. So with that and that, and then we're going to go every other one here. Which matches up to there, which is good. Alright, so that actually worked out really well. Maybe we're going to get a little lucky today, I don't know. That's 2, so there. And that's going to continue out a little bit. I still need to figure out the rest of that corner. But what we're going to do is we're just going to basically bring it back a couple of blocks each time we go up, and then I'll come back and do the corners. So we've got that. We're going to go ahead and match rotation again. And the reason we're doing it this way is because once we have this set up, the next tier up is the one that's going to basically be the next floor. So we go there. We're not using axes, so what we will do is we'll do this. But this is why it's so important to get all of your support structure figured out first. So that you have enough room to get around up here. I mean, I could have just built the shell and gone with it, but eh. It's okay. It's all good. I'll show you what we're going to do with this here in a second. Alright, so now that we have all of that done, that's 1, 2. This is going to go. Let's grab this. Connect this here. And then this is going to come out. And basically what's going to happen is this is going to tie into the next face over here that we're doing. So now that we have all that, Go ahead and tie all this in really quickly. Just a bit more of this. It's always fun doing these big builds because you're never quite sure what you're gonna get, you know, because you have an idea. You're like designing, you're saying, okay, this is what I want to do, but you're never quite sure if it is actually gonna work out the way that you want it to. And I think that's one of the reasons why I like the games like 7 Days to Die and Apeiron and Space Engineers, because you can do this kind of stuff and it's just like, it's crazy the things that you can achieve if you. Ah, crap. Can't believe I just did that. Come on. So, take this out. That's all of those. So now what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and grab this. We're basically going to go just like this. We basically want all of this to fill in. I'm trying to be a little bit more careful because I have a horrible time placing these blocks sometimes. So if I seem like I'm going a little bit slower, my apologies. Right. And that's going to be basically the end of that. So we're going to go. We're going to do this just to get it tied in. And then this is going to go here. Right. Should be 2, right? Yes, 1, 2, and then a floor. Okay. Come on. All right, so we need to go grab more of our parts, which should, in theory, be done or mostly done at this point. Nice thing is that because of the slope we have, we can just go whoop, down, down. Oh, that was close. Okay. Hey, look. Oh, that's right. Ah, crap. Alright, let's try that again. Now some of them are taking damage. How are you taking damage? Hmm. I'm guessing it's shooting itself. Alright, we may have to adjust that level there a little bit. Alright, so. Alright. So we're gonna go up this way. Now for those who are asking, on the 2x1 ramps, if you actually run, you're able to get back up there. Right. Sounded like, all right. So we're gonna do this. Since we took them off our inventory, we have to come back and reorient them. And yeah, I know I made this floor a little bit low. I went ahead and connected it at 3 instead of 4. That's okay. Because what we're going to do now is we're going to go ahead and grab that, grab this. And we are going to go... Yes. Hey, Sharky. How you doing, buddy? Welcome to the stream. Sounds like we may have gotten a horde. No, just random zombie spawn. Okay. Random zombies, not a problem. So the reason this is going to be important is because we need to have this really, really secure. We're going to come back and we're going to put the next level of windows on. And I think that puts us on par. Yep. So we should hopefully be able to get this level done between the two walls today. Hopefully. We need to go down there and firm up that... giant column of rebar too. Yeah. All right, so we want you are here, so that's going to be one here, two and one here, and basically we just go here, here, here. And yeah, that's going to be the corner. We'll probably have to come back and dig some of this out, but that's okay. Come on. And that's going to be the corner. It's going to meet here. Be that way. Shut. We can just do that. So we're gonna have that there. It's gonna go in two, and it should be there, I believe. We're gonna find out here in a second. Cause this is going to be two windows there. Is that right? Yeah. Okay. And that was two there. Yeah. Window. Come on. Give me my pickaxe. There you go. That window goes away. We've got this. Okay. Now, why do you look like you have taken damage? Oh, no, I guess not. Alright, so that gets us here. That's a double window. Window. Try that one more time. There we go. Alright. That's all good. That's all good. You know, we're just gonna go ahead and close that off to make it a little bit easier to get stuff in here. We're getting closer here. Let me go ahead and go. Hey, look. Zombie. Hello, zombie. Whoops. Sure. I know, I used more ammo than I needed to. It's okay. I'll just make more. I actually think I have the supplies to make like another 1,000 rounds or something like that already. So I'm not too worried about it. Brass is starting to get a little bit thin though, so I will probably need to go on a looting run here in the near future. Now we start tying all this together, and we're going to do the same thing that we did there. So we're going to bring this out and about a little bit, because we want to secure that up a little bit, because we're going to take this one out. So there we go. See? And basically this lets us be able to continue working. All right. So we want you to go away. You're going to become frames again. What am I doing? I'm actually building a giant pyramid. So you're not too far off with the Temple of Zombies there. I hear a screamer. Where is she at? So what I'm working on right now is the support system for our Temple of Zombie. Because this is a very, very large build. Ah, crap, I didn't want to do that. That was close. Okay. There we go. And up. Your router died? Yeah, basically what we're doing is we're building a we're building the Transamerica Pyramid from San Francisco. At least a building that's inspired by it. There are build limitations within the game that just don't allow me to build exactly the way I want it to. But should be interesting when it's done, at least, I hope. You know, worst case scenario, you can always bring it into your game if for those who want it. Should be able to make the biome available to you. All right, so we've got that, we got that. I'm gonna need to go back down and firm all of those up. Right. It is a rather large build, that is for sure. And part of it is I also want the building to be functional when it's done, so I'm going to be building a lot more into it. Like, we'll eventually come back and fill in, or the idea is to eventually come back and fill in the entirety of each floor. So all of this from that level up is going to be completely filled in. So you'll be able to, if you wanted to use it for your own builds, you'd be able to basically build in your own interior walls. I've got you hooked on Space Engineers. It's easy to do. It's a good game. I'm planning on doing tomorrow and Thursday will be Space Engineers Day. We'll be doing pre-records for videos for Empyrean. So if you're an Empyrean fan, that is not going away. It will be making a comeback, but that will be on YouTube. So once I have them uploaded on YouTube, I'll probably make them videos on demand here on Twitch as well. We'll see how that goes. If there's interest in it. If there isn't, then you know. So we'll have two spaceship series, a zombie series, and then I'm thinking I may do another series as well, but I'm not sure what it's going to be yet. Because Star Citizen 3.0 is getting ready to launch. I'm actually expecting that. I'm expecting it probably end of the month. So we'll see how that actually works out, but I'm hoping that they'll be able to hit their timelines again, so. Now, is this all done over here? Yeah. Okay. Just wanted to make sure that that was actually done. No worries, Sharky. So I am still playing around with the schedule timings. I know I want to basically be live streaming at least 4 days a week, which is the days will not change, but the times might. So if this is too early or too late for people, let me know. I'm trying to make it easy for everybody to find the content that they want and that they enjoy. And it's much easier to do if everyone lets me know what schedules work great for them, so. There you go. The reason why we did that is so that we can do this. I hear zom-zoms. Hey, look! Roaming horde. Nice of her to put the head in the basket for us.
Alright.
We have zombies downstairs, or are they just kind of wandering through? So we don't seem to be detected. You know what? Let's go clean up the zombies that are down here. We've got zom-zoms. They're like short shorts, but not as entertaining. Come here, guys. Pop. Pop. Turn around. Face me like a cheerleader. It'd be nice if I would actually be able to swing here. Come on. Thank you. Get rid of all these zombies. I just don't like having a bunch of horde zombies around because they tend to cause more trouble than they're worth. Come on. Wow, there's some chunk going on the game today. Right. What's wrong, buddy? Need a hand? And we'll come back through and probably clean the rest of this up later. Everybody else despawned? Great. There. Getting a whole lot of shorts off of folks. The cheerleaders are, I guess, wearing bloomers. I'm not sure here. Let's see. So, come on, thank you. Yeah, I think I've gone too long without restarting my system. So, really? Just scrap these. Any good? No. Of course not. That'd be entirely too easy. And I don't really need the cloth. I can make cloth. That's unfortunately can't make feathers. So, do you have anything in your inventory? Just fuel, okay. And drop that off. Alright. Alrighty then. Yeah, I'm just being lazy. Didn't feel like going into my inventory to swap things out for the hatchet again. Right, so we are going to go this away because we want to be up on the top row here. Yes. Yeah. Okay. See, nice and simple, right? So basically what this is this is really, this is how we tie the face to the rest of the building and keep our structural integrity. I had a couple of people ask me why I do it this way, and that's basically the reason why. Alright, so I just need, you can go away. Yes, okay. And you. Feels like there should be. Oh. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Aha! Should be another one right there. Ha ha ha! That would be why. Alright. Alright, so let's go ahead and grab these, and what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and Come on. There we go. This is going to be the corner. So now we will grab this one. And we should have some more cement downstairs, so we'll be able to make some more of these wedges. Am I going to be close enough? And we'll take a look at what we've gotten done so far, because we are almost out of time here. Well, for the day so far, not for the stream. And then we do two rows of here because the small piece is where our next floor begins. Want to make sure we are not about to walk off anything more than we need to there. I don't know. Now we have another floor done. Yay! Alright. Turn your match rotation. Always fun trying to figure out your corners and such. So we're gonna go here. Start running ourselves backwards again. And once we have this in, we'll be able to build the next floor. I'm going to take a quick look here, show you what... Oh, hello. That could have been entertaining in a bad way. Well, entertaining for you in a good way, entertaining for me in a bad way. And we're going to go... Should be... Or there, is that it? I think that's it, right? Yes, okay. So we might have some on this side that still need to be done. Let's check, make sure. Anything over here? Nope, oh, looks good. Okay, so let's go here. Show you what we got going on. Give you a little bit of a distance preview. Because what we're going to do is we're going to need to get a bunch of things done today for this. So not doing too bad. So that's what we've got so far. That block is going to have to come out. So yeah, that's basically what we've got going on so far. That is going to continue up at that rate, which means it's probably going to end somewhere around there or so, and then it'll go up into a... I'll turn that into like an observation slash gunnery tower or something. Maybe even put like a workshop or something up there. We'll definitely have some lighting up there. Okay, let's clean this up. You have already been searched, yes. Okay. So, that gets us there. And like I said, yeah, that's going to have to come out. Maybe not. Maybe not. We can probably make that work. No, it's going to have to come out. That block has to come out. Alright. Up we go. Oh, come on. I've been walking on walls all day. Alright. Ah, I don't have any fuel. What? I thought I had gas on me. Son of a... Alright, let's go grab some gas. I know I have some in the bike, so we'll just grab it there. I don't need much. Let's grab what we have. Up we go. I need to start carrying my chainsaw with me as well. It's more entertaining killing zombies with it. There you are. Let's try that again. Come on, let me up. Really? There we go. Walking on the ledge? Yes. My apologies for the large amount of noise. Really? So if you're doing that, let's go ahead and... Son of a... I keep hitting left click. I'm gonna... It's like I've been playing so much Space Engineers that when I get into other games, I keep forgetting. Some of them it's left click, some of them it's right click to place. Alright, so that gets us that. Yes. Okay. So I'm gonna go grab more cement. Actually, what are we doing for our food? Is a little low. I don't think I brought any food over with me. I might have to go back to the other base to get something to eat. We have food? Yeah, we have that. That'll work. So drop some of this miscellaneous crap off here. We are almost out of that. And what we're going to do is we're going to keep, I think we're going to keep going a little bit tonight. How are you doing? So, you guys get to come down here. But on the flip side, look at all that cement. So, plenty of cement. We're going to make, how much money? Oh, no, actually, we got a bunch of those, so I don't need to really make I've only used. How many did we start with? 200 or 300? I think we started with 300, right? So let's move our ammo and stuff down here. We'll move this stuff up. Okay, there we go. Oh, let's see here. Let me eat one of these. I guess it's the 47. Eat this. Eat another one. And yeah, that should be good. That should keep us alive. Okay. There's just no barriers. I definitely do not want those. Let's go ahead and drink the water. Okay. There we go. Come on. Let me turn. Thank you. Swear. Game going crazy. Ugh. Chunky. Fungus Nine Monster, thanks for the follow, man. Appreciate it. We're gonna have quite a bit more 7 Days to Die stuff going on. This is a ginormous build, so yeah, we're gonna be here for a while. Let's go. You know what? Oh, come on. Let me up the ladder. Sheesh. I swear, man. I don't know why they keep changing the collision on that crap. Damn, it's annoying. Alright, so this is going to come back now. We're going to go put these in here. So what we're doing is we want 3 blocks of headspace. That's why I bring these back so far. It's also why I doubled the previous floor. Just because I need to make sure we're going to be able to tie all this together without killing ourselves. Yeah, welcome to the channel, Funk. Appreciate it. Yeah, tying the structural integrity is always fun. Like I said, at least Mad Mole and the Fun Pimps ended up making structural integrity a little bit easier to deal with in Alpha 16. Still annoying, but, you know, not quite as much. So. Now if they would just make the block targeting not so twitchy. So many streamers, yeah. So many streamers, so little time, right? I know the feeling. I'm the same way. I like to try and catch as many of the streamers as possible, especially for the games that I'm interested in. There's for the 7 Days to Die stuff and Space Engineers, which are the two big games that I'm doing right now. Imperion is in there as well, but I'm not really live streaming that one. But all the communities for all three of those games are actually really supportive of each other, and it's great to see. So. Always great to have more people join any one of the channels. You know, the community is always growing, so good things there.
Itchy nose.
So, let's see here. Hopefully that will help illuminate the process here for you. Okay, so we are continuing this build all the way up. So what I'm thinking I may do is I may go ahead and like basically just do what I did on the side before, continue it up a couple of floors, and then have this side catch up on it. Oh, so much cement. At some point I will have to sit down and actually track it. I actually had, when I first started the build, I had wanted to keep an accurate count on how much I was using, but I was just using so much of it so quickly that I lost track. Yes, we are building a pyramid that is inspired by the Transamerica Pyramid in San Francisco. Since I live in the Bay Area, I thought it would be nice to do a little tribute build. So it's only going to make it about halfway up this tower, unfortunately, because of the way the frames work in the game. But eh. All right, so let us drop down. We're going to go ahead and firm that up. Pick that block up. The fun part's going to be when I go to bring up the next row, because the next row is all the way down there. So I'm going to have to run the supports all the way up here and then tie them in to the floor there so we can start backing up the next level of floor. This one I actually already did that on, which I'm really wishing I had done that on the other one now. Ugh. Looks like we lost music again. Here, let me no, we're gonna go to a new song. There we go. That's always a fun. Well, it's gonna be a couple of different calculations, Sharky, because eventually each of these floors, the floor areas here, will go from where they are to the center. So it's gonna be a ridiculous amount of cement. And then just to show you how this is going to work. Basically, this is what we've done for each of the floors. And then on this one, basically, we're going to have to start bringing those supports up and tie it into the rest of the structure. So, fun stuff. All right, and you're going to go like so. Like that. Okay. And then that just gives us our little ramp or our little ladder area to continue that up. And this should be two windows behind me. Yes, okay. And there. Alright. So it is. We're gonna do it here. And like so. I think this is actually, I don't know if this is my biggest build ever. Definitely one of the bigger ones, that's for. Which is actually kind of frightening when you stop and think about that. I think I've done bigger builds than this. I think this is the most detailed though that I've actually done. But I like doing the builds like this. It's always fun to just see what you can create. You're lazy? Yeah, I know you're lazy. That's fine, Sharky. We all know you. It's all good. For anyone who may not know, Sharky is one of the folks that I actually do multiplayer stuff with from time to time. So he's a YouTuber in his own right. For the folks that are joining us this afternoon, welcome to the stream. Hopefully you had a fantastic weekend and the beginning of your week has been nothing but terrific. What we are doing is we are working in 7 Days to Die. We are working on our Trans-America Pyramid Building, inspired by, I should say. 7 Days to Die, unfortunately, does not like the angles that they used in the real Trans-America Pyramid, so it's not going to be easy to build, but, you know, we can get close. We can get close. We definitely get a nice feel for the build. Tie all that together. I'm just gonna go ahead and run down here and get all this in. And for those asking, yes, we are actually in survival mode. Everything that we are placing has been built in-game using in-game resources and collection. This is not creative mode. So we do get the zombies, we get the heat map zombies, we get the sleepers, all the fun. We are in day 36. Yeah, I know, right? Okay, so 7 Days to Die. I've had a couple of people ask how I get so much resource so quickly. I got lucky with getting an auger fairly early in the game. I was like day 20-ish or so. Basically, if you want to be able to build really big things in 7 Days to Die, kill every zombie you can find and loot every box that you can find. That's the big secret. And you do that for like the first 10 days or so in game. I have changed a little bit about my strategies now. With Alpha 16, I have found there's a couple of things that work really, really well early game now. Make sure you have at least 2 traders on the map and that you have at least 1 major town or a couple of smaller towns. And that'll be the fastest way to level up. And basically what you do is you spend the first like two in-game days doing nothing but harvesting clay and stone. Resource rocks if you can find them while you're out and about and searching for your towns. Once you have all of that, by the time you've gotten through the first 2 days, if all you do is constantly loot everything and harvest materials, You'll be level 20 in like the first day. But yeah, finding the auger early on is probably one of the best things that happened. Which is funny because I don't use it that often. What I started doing was basically I'll use the auger at night if I'm not building. When I start getting low on stone, I'll just go pick a direction, take like 3,000 fuel with me, and go in a straight line. And then I'll come back and, you know, widen it up. I'll make it like 3 blocks tall, 3 blocks wide. So. All right. But when you start with the forges, when you start making your forges and you start making your campfires and things, make for forges, I say, if you're going to do a build like this, you have to do at least 4 forges. If you're doing anything less than 4 forges, you're not going to get anything done. Oh, crap. Keep doing that. There we go. There we go. If you're looking for resource harvesting, see, there's a bit of argument back and forth on which is better, a steel pickaxe at 600 or an auger at 500 plus. So if you're using the auger, you actually go through the material faster, but you get the XP much faster with the auger than you do with the pickaxe. So once you have the auger, if you just want a power level, that's the best way to do it. That, at least in my opinion. I don't really use the auger for much except for basically force leveling. Alright, so we need to bring that back. Hello, chunky system. There we go. Oh, come on. Game has gotten chunky. There it goes. Yeah, and if you're actually resourcing, I always say use the pickaxe because you can control, like, if you're doing if you're mining specifically for like expansion area, things like that, it's much easier to do it with a pickaxe. If you're trying to get like specific designs, if you're just out bulk resourcing, though, yeah, pickaxe or auger. Auger, oi, 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 right? And there we go. Sorry if I end up going a little quiet. I'm just trying to focus on the build because I've gotten to the point where if I start falling, the impact may break the stuff that I'm standing on. So. We're almost there. Okay. Just a couple of more brilliant. Just a couple of more frames. What's going to be sad is I'm going to have to nerd pull back up here to to put all of this back. Or to fill all of this in, rather. Come on. There we go. Firm this up so we don't accidentally pull stuff out. If you've ever seen any of my live streams or videos, you know that I tend to do that from time to time. There we go. Funny, you should mention that. Actually, on the multiplayer server for the Broken Ankle community, I am doing an underwater build. Yeah. Every time you upgrade, it leaks. It's all so much more fun. Yeah, so if anybody's looking for a challenge, yeah, try building underwater sometime in 7 Days to Die. Ever since they got the water flow mechanics done, much more difficult than it used to be. You know, I used to build underwater all the time. That was my favorite place to build. Because it gave you the same benefit as digging to bedrock without having to dig to bedrock. Ah, no, 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 no. Thank you. That would have been bad. But yeah, this is basically what I do off camera. I just, when in between live streams, I do most of this build. There. Ah, crap. Oh, that was close. Okay. I really do not like the new collision ladders. Of course, you know, I need to go back down there and do that pillar now. Crap. All right. Can I get? Yeah. Alright, yeah. I think that's the right level. Yes, yes. Sharky is actually Bulgarian. And he swears like an English sailor, so, you know, it's like. So be careful when you get him going, because once you get him started, you'll never get him to stop. Yeah, you can. Yeah, the bearded guys. You know, I love Joe and everybody, and but they I don't know, the underwater stuff. I think they're scared to do it. I know it's gonna get me in trouble on the BGG channel, but they are worried about trying to build underwater. The thing I don't like about building underwater is that it does create more problems than it solves. Mainly in the fact that building underwater does weird things, especially in multiplayer, because of all the desync issues. I love, like I said, I love BGG, but they tend to be a little bit more conservative on the areas that they build in. Like they'll build in areas that are easy to maintain and defend and such. And there's nothing wrong with that. Don't get me wrong. You know, I'm not calling them out or anything like that. Just saying that their build preferences are much different than mine, as far as like location selection go. In Alpha 16, I'm probably gonna start rethinking my choices, because like I said earlier, I don't like some of the changes that Joel and the guys over at the Fun Pimps have made to the zombie spawning system. The sleepers are a great addition, but the changes that they've made to heat map are really, really annoying. So it should be. Like all light sources now add to heat or all player light sources add to heat map now, including burning barrels, which I think is a really crappy thing to do. But is what it is. you know, TFP and Joel have always said that they're going to build the game they want to build, and everybody else can play it or, you know, piss off, so. Yeah, the whole sleeper system, like I said, I really like the sleeper system. I think it adds something to the game that it's been missing for a very long time. Really did bring back the jump scare elements to zombie survival games. But the system, yeah, it needs work. It needs a little bit of work. Just a little bit of love, it'll be okay. Framed up. Now the changes to structural integrity and the decay system, I actually like those. The fact that guns don't decay when you repair them now, I think is rather awesome. And I hope that is a change that stays. Of course, having said that, Joel, if Joel sees this, he's probably going to say, hey, wait a minute, that's a bug. So, for those who don't know, TFP's standard for if it's a bug is it beneficial to players? If it's beneficial to players, it's a bug. Leg decay, yeah. Red, don't give him suggestions, man. Were you playing 7 Days to Die when we had the issue, or was it back in? Was it Alpha 9? I think it was Alpha 9. Is Alpha 9, Alpha 10, something like that? Basically, if you jumped, you sprained your leg. It was a bug. It wasn't supposed to be that bad. But really, if you were running and you jumped because you get a small boost in the height for how fast you're moving forward when you jump. Basically, if you were running and you jumped on flat terrain, like I could be doing this, jump, land, and would sprain my ankle in the game. Alpha 14, nice. Alpha 14 was a lot of fun. That was a good time to start in the game. A lot of the challenge was starting to come back to the game. We started having the changes to the heat maps. We started having, was that the Alpha 14 was when the quality system I think was first introduced. Like the whole concept of what eventually became the workbench system. Go ahead and get the rest of this in here. The broken ankle recordings. Yeah, Alpha 9, I think. That was Endoms. Originally, it was Endoms and Games for Kicks back when they were both under the 1,000 mark. I think they were around 1,000. Subscribers at that point, or yeah, on YouTube. I've known Endoms and Games for Kicks. Let's see, I think Endoms was at about 500 subscribers when I first started following him, and Games for Kicks was around the same. I think he was around, he had just hit like 500 or so. Oh, the console release? Now, I'm not gonna lie. I am fairly impressed with what they were able to achieve for the console release. Now, keep in mind, though, that TFP isn't actually developing it. TFP just did the original code, and they worked with 2K Games to build the console version. And then 2K Games develops the console version. So, Which is why some of the things that you see in the PC version haven't made it to console yet. Some of it's technology limitations, some of it's, you know, politics with the developer. Well, I should say the publisher. So, we'll go down one more floor. Start tying this stuff together. Can I get to you from there? Yeah. But you can always tell the old school structural integrity guys in 7 Days to Die, because we tend to over-engineer everything. Because basically you used to be able to trick structural integrity in the game by doing stupid stuff like this. Because it's calculated vertically. There we go. And since it's calculated vertically, what you could do is, in order to get around the shear requirements, is you just build two supports. Well, if you tie them together, what happens is that it becomes, the entire structure becomes registered as a structural support though. Even if you don't have the entire thing filled in like this. I just fill it in because I like having it a little bit more secure, you know? Build flying house? Yeah. I haven't built a flying house in a while. I'm actually going to be building one here in the near future. Somebody asked about it, so I'm going to build a floating house. You can still do it in Alpha 16. No matter what Joel and the company say. I get yelled at because I show that stuff off. Like, what? Don't tell me you can't do it, and then you know, if I can figure out a way to do it, I will. This one gets a little extra just because we've got the ladder over here. It makes it a little easier to find it when we're looking. Yeah, and they haven't fixed that yet, Sharky. You can still do it. It's actually a little bit easier now, believe it or not. Right. Oh yeah. You know, exploiting this game's broken physics is, it should be an e-sport. It really should be an e-sport. Come on. No. You know what? It's not the garage doors you need, it's the drawbridge. Because you can place drawbridges vertically now. So what you do is you build a drawbridge, place it in so that it is clips through the ground when it's being placed. So the drawbridge in its closed position is vertical. You can then put a plate in the middle of that. It's like about two blocks off the ground. And when you put the plate in, you open up the drawbridge and the plate stays. So you get the hovering effect like you do with a plate, but it's like two blocks up and it just goes, the zombies walk straight through it. They can't hit it at all. which I probably shouldn't be telling people because, you know, TFP gets mad about the whole highlighting exploits thing, so. But yeah, it's doable. It's a little expensive. Actually, I have the materials for it. You know what? It's almost daylight. Let's head back to the base. We'll head back to the actual base. Anybody over here? Yeah, no. Okay. Let's head back to the actual base, and we will start making a garage door. If I'm gonna get in trouble for talking about it, I may as well get in trouble for showing it, right? Whee! For the folks who haven't been to the channel before, this is my normal base. Welcome to the home base. So you can see it from outside. Is that a screamer? That is a screamer. I'm gonna detect it. Ah, crap. Ah! What was that? What the? What was that? Holy crap! I just got sniped or something. The hell? Which base is this at? Yeah, there was no puke. Ah, crap, I'm all the way over here, really? Oh, bloody hell. Well, this is bad. Alright. I forgot to move my bedroll. That's my first death in this game so far, in this playthrough. Almost 2,300 zombies killed. Alright, do I have any materials over here? I don't think I have anything. Nope. Oh, crap. So, to give you an idea where I am... Okay, so we're over here. The big building I'm building is over here. And my base is over there. So, straight lining it, I guess. Right. What do I need for that? I need 100 iron. Ah, okay, no, my auger is here. Let's see, there should be... I need forged iron, which is quick. Do I have clay in here? No. Oh, but that's okay, I have that. Whoop, nope, come back here. I'm gonna throw that in there. Okay, they're not running anymore. So, really old base for the folks that weren't here for the beginning of it. This is my old crafting station area. I moved everything out of here. So this is my old crafting area. I never finished really building this, unfortunately. A couple of levels of underground farming. So, you know, we have the nice underground farm. Our day 7 horde base was over here. I think there's some food in there, actually. Do I have... See, I tend to leave the bases around behind me. So just in case stuff like this happens. Spiked club, I can repair that. Oh no, I can't because I don't have any forged metal. Or forged iron. So there should be some food in there, right? Yep. One more of those. Okay. Oh yeah, I do have a machete. Forgot about that. Good catch, Sharky. Alright. So now we're gonna run our butts all the way back over there. I cannot believe... I swear that was... So, I don't normally, that had to be a glitch death. It had to be. Come on. Oh, no worries. We'll be here. But, in celebration of me being killed... To do it. Is it not doing it? Hold on. That would be a zom-zom. There you go. In celebration of me dying. Hey, Farmer John. How you doing, buddy? Oh, look, all my resource rocks respawned. Nice. Okay, this is gonna be a long run back. And can you tell that I've come through here a couple of times? Flip side, it means we can pick up more feathers and eggs. Loot some of the chests. We can always use more eggs. I'm really thinking I may put in the chicken coop mod. Come here, buddy. So that's one of the reasons why I don't use the machete, because I don't have a lot of edge skill in the game. All of my skills are on the clubs. So it's easier for me to one-shot them with even just a regular wooden club than it is with the machete right now. Just because we can. And that is what the auger does. To resource rocks. Treasure map. Which one is it? Oh. Yeah, we're gonna read that. Let's try that again. I hit escape too quickly. Where is the treasure? Treasure is down there. Side trip. Actually, do I have a shovel? No, I don't have a shovel. Crap. What am I missing? I'm missing plant fiber. Look, I have plant fiber. Okay, so let's craft one. I should probably make a wooden bow too, huh? Yeah, fishing weights. There you go. So let's make a bow really quickly. Get rid of that. Bring you over there. See? Nice and easy. Actually, no. Keep the bow in case we run into dogs or wolves. I mean, they're just going to give me resource rocks, right? So I may as well. Hey, buddy. Nice suit. You're only carrying paper. I use it. Not worth it. Were you saying that you're out, Sharky? Okay. I thought that's what you were saying. Alright, well, thanks for stopping in, buddy. Appreciate it. Hope you had some fun. Enjoy your day. I think you're probably at work right now, right? Running uphill! Anything good? No, of course not. Why would there be anything good in this tree stump, right? Come on. The only thing I really dislike about dying is the loss of the 10 wellness. That's the only thing that pisses me off about it. Well, that sexy talk is between you and Red, buddy. Oh, okay, so. Should be getting close. Right. Oh, it's down in the. It's in a bad part of town. Oh, I think we're gonna have to go up the road here. Yeah, we'll wear that. That's fine. I need to get a better one. I haven't really been worrying about my armor too much. Apparently, that was a bad thing to do. It's fine. We can make the rest of it work. See, See, there's methods of my madness. I know I'm burning fuel, so basically that helps get the stuff and get the fuel out of my inventory, which opens up another slot. At the same time, I'm gathering resources, so. We've got zom-zoms. Right. Now, if we get really lucky, it'll be on the surface. If we get really unlucky, it'll be down in the valley. I hate the burnt biome almost as much as I hate the wasteland biomes. Wasteland biomes are bad, bad stuff. Okay, so it's somewhere in this general area. Oh, hello. How are you, buddy? Not hunted anymore. Okay. So what we're going to do is we are going to go like so. 2, 3. Whoop. We want it to go there. Okay, so it's that spot. We're going to head north. For those who don't know the triangulation trick, this is the triangulation trick. So that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 19, 21. So what is 21? 10, 11. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So if you go that away, what we're doing is we're looking for the center of where this thing goes away. So that's going to be 2, 3, 4, 5, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Actually, that was perfect. Now what we're going to do is we are going to grab our shovel, swap that around so we can have things about where they're supposed to be. And what you want to do is you basically just find the middle and then choose a direction to start digging in. Now, the chest is only like 2 to 3 blocks below the surface. So if you start digging too far, what you might do is you might undercut it. So you want to be careful. Check your angles. I didn't find it that way. I'm probably going to be over this way. But it should show up for you somewhere. Somewhere in this area. There's a zombie. I hear a zombie. I hear a burning zombie. Where is you at, buddy? Told you I heard one. Oh, half second too early. I can't tell if I'm just firing over him. Oh, that hit got hit by the tree. Yeah, I'm not a fan of the burnt biome. I actually like the burnt biome more than I do the wasteland biome. There we go. Simply because of the fact that I don't have to deal with the dogs as often. I am betting this thing is going to be like in here somewhere. Can't tell if that was. Did I find it there? See, I always get the. I hate when I get them on the hillside because you end up having to dig forever and a bloody day to find the thing. It's so much better when you're on the plains and you find them. Much, much easier to find your treasure chest that way. Because if it's on the hill, if you're not careful, when you're digging it up, you will sometimes underdig it, and the treasure chest falls and destroys itself. So you always want to be careful when you're doing this, because you never know when the whole thing is going to just come down and destroy whatever you're trying to get out of there. Okay, so it's not there, it's not there. I'm gonna be mad, aren't I? I have a feeling I'm about to be mad. Doing this with a stone shovel is annoying. Alright. Alright, so nothing here. Come on, it's got to be somewhere right around here. Be nice to me. Be nice to me. RNG, you've been doing nothing but giving me crap all day. Come on. So now the question is it going to be on this side or this side? Yeah, I know you're there, buddy. You know what? That's how you know I'm serious. When I break out the auger, All right. Well, that didn't do much for me, did it? Man, I hate looking for these things. See, now I can't give up on it just on general principle. See if we can find this thing. I want my treasure chest. Oh, is that it? I hear another burnt zombie. Zombie flambe. Alright. It's the flambe zombie. Right, come on. Give me the jam chest. I have never had to dig this much for a treasure chest. Ever. I have never dug this much. This is crazy. Hey Spear Eyes, how you doing? No, I'm usually pretty good about finding them. That's why I'm surprised that it's taking me this long. At least I know I didn't destroy it because it's still showing up on radar, but yeah, this is the most digging I have ever had to do for one of these chests. I am not happy about this. Yeah, a grenade launcher would be good. That'd be a hell of a way to go digging for treasure chests. Do that in real life, right? How you doing today, man? Hope you're having a fantastic day. Welcome to the stream. I think I actually have the points available. I should just go ahead and put points into it. Alright, so that's there. So really the only place for it to still be is either in this little batch over here. Using grenade launcher for gardening? Awesome. Okay, this thing is just yeah, 'cause there's only a couple of places it really could be at this point. And I'm wondering if I uncovered it and I'm just not seeing it. You see, there's going to be a little bit of space, come on, around it when you break in. It'll give you an, hi. Really? All right. See, I thought this was going to be nice, easy treasure hunt. No. No. No, Hal. Why would we give you an easy treasure hunt? Oh, if you want to do treasure hunting, I definitely recommend picking up the skills. Yeah. Because just being able to narrow down where it's spawning at is beneficial, as you can see. Usually it spawns close to the middle, but apparently I got the RN. There it is. Look at you. We can get rid of that 6,000 dirt fragments. Another 2,000 dirt fragments. Alright. You know what? I'm not even going to worry about picking up the rest of the frames. I'm just going to take that one and go. Nah, that was the crappy loot. Some of the chest loot that you can get, especially if you do the treasure hunter, like if you level it up, some of the loot you can get like stacks of dukes. I've seen somebody pull like 40,000 dukes or just shy of 40,000 dukes out of one treasure chest before. Oh, I hear puppy. Thank you for your sacrifice, puppy. Oh, Spear Eyes, thanks for the follow. I appreciate that. Zombie down. She's carrying dog food. Now we know why the wolf was around. Alright. So, we're out of fuel. So the lights that you see over there are my base. We'll get back to that eventually. Oh, hello. That would have been painful. Right. Excuse me, miss. I have a message for you.
You did.
All right. That's actually useful. Now that we can break moldy bread down. Any good? No, of course not. Any good? No, of course not. Hey, buddy. Ah! Have I been here before? Okay, I've been here before. I'm not gonna waste my time exploring the bases that I've already explored. So we're gonna set quick waypoint there, that way we know which way we're heading. And we can follow the road. Alright. Head up this way. Hello, puppy. For those who don't know, I do have a dog. You will hear him from time to time, and you will sometimes hear me complain when he has a loose butt, because he will let gas out. The witch has been, you know, Geneva Convention violations come out of that dog's butt. Anyone who has ever had a dog knows exactly what I am talking about. Do we have scrap metal? Is there anything I... No, that's okay. I've got more than enough metal. I don't need the nails. Yeah, so we have these treats that we give him. He gets them at night, right before bed. Basically, it's like chicken jerky. Sometimes they will have apple in them. Sometimes they have banana in them. The ones that he's on the big kick with right now have bacon in them. Hey Shades, how you doing, buddy? Welcome to the stream. No, I cannot read this. Twitch acting up on you again? I know a couple of people have been complaining about the Twitch chat not working properly for them. We are on foot because we got a ninja strike from one of the zombies. It's almost like I shot an arrow and killed myself or something. Like maybe I shot an arrow straight up and ended up where the arrow landed. I don't know. That is... I think I've been here too, right? Nope, that's a new one. Alright, let's get over here. I don't know why my game is so chunky today. Yeah, I haven't been in there yet. Alright. But before we do that... Oh! He moved! There we go. I mean, if I'm going to be hunted by zombies anyway, may as well make the most of it, right? Oh, hello. How are you, buddy? Whoop. A cowboy hat. If I wanted to be a cowboy. Explain chunky game. Basically, every so often, my gameplay starts slowing down. And I'm not sure what's up with it today. I'm thinking it's probably because... Oh, you know what? I don't have any of my tools with me. I do have my pickaxe. Make sure we got no spawns behind us. I really hate using my pickaxe to open stuff, but I'm actually surprised there's nothing in here. Make sure no one's spawning behind me. Oh, look at you. Ooh. You know what? You are actually useful. You are actually useful. And scrap those back for the wood. We almost have stuff worth taking. It's more of a issue because of the fact that I haven't restarted my system in like 4 days. So, hello, puppy. Puppy is saying hello to the internet. Internet, say hello to the puppy. What am I dropping? Whoa, I don't want to be dropping raw iron now. Fat we will drop. I've got a couple hundred units of fat. I don't care about the fat. I do want the iron though. I figured we're here, may as well pick it up, right? Yeah, it's just I haven't rebooted my machine, and I've been uploading videos and streaming a lot lately, so between the Adobe stuff, all of the different games, yeah, it just basically the memory is a little sloppy right now, so. It's okay. It's all good. Another nest? No. Is there actually a trader right nearby? Oh, there is a trader here. We'll stop in and take a look at the trader, see what he has. I actually found a treasure map on one of the traders once that I didn't sell to him. I didn't think those spawned on the traders, so I'm not sure if that was a bug or what. It was pretty funny though. What's wrong, Shades? We can see your chat. You having problems with the chat or something, or only 1 out of 10 go through? That is rather annoying. I don't have you in slowdown mode, so chat should be real time. Oh, and for those who don't know, one of the recent changes that they did when they did the micro patch, you can't pick up the burning barrels over here anymore. That kind of annoys me. Let's see here. Are they good? I'm trying to remember if this one's the one with all the broken ones or not. Oh, he's got that. Okay. And more coal. Okay. Now, Shades, are you having that same problem with everybody, or is it just mine? Doesn't want to buy it. Okay, so I think I have all the paintings, right?
Yeah.
So what you got here? Anything useful? Ooh, look at you. We'll buy you. That'll replace the one I've got. I already have all those. Room and inventory. Oh, what do I have? You know what? Get rid of that. Oh, not get rid of that. Almost threw the bullets away. That would have been bad. It would have been funny, but here we go. And let's see here. Oh, look at you. I'm gonna have to come back for you. I'm definitely gonna have to come back for you. Alright, what do you have for chemicals?
No refund, deal's done. Now feed it, fucker.
No chat profile. Oh. Hey, look, we can see our base from over here. Wow, I didn't realize my base was that lit up.
Okay.
At some point, I am going to build a bridge over all of this crap, just so I can get over here a little bit easier. All right, let's see here. I know there's a way down over here. I think it was. Yeah, it's over here. Hey Demon, how you doing, buddy? Welcome to the stream. Hope you're having a fantastic week so far. Do a little bit of 7 days to die today. There we go. So this is why I don't come over to this trader very often, because he's a pain in the ass to get up to and from. Back from. Alright, so let's go get this stuff done. For those who missed it, I had my first death today. I'm very sad. 37 days in game, I was able to go. I died at the end of day 36. We were on the way back to the base. Took a shot at one of the screamer zombies. Hello, how are you? Well, you got meat in you. Yeah, get rid of that. Respawn, thank you. Not really worried about it. We can make paper, it's fine. So yes, I am very sad by that. Your summer fail? Yeah. So how's your summer car going there, buddy? I know you've been trying to get Rongo to play more, right? Had a bunch of people asking Rongo to play that game. I looked at it. Nope. That's a game that would make me rage quit the internet. I don't like car engines enough to play my summer car, so. Oh, thanks, Damon. Appreciate that. Apparently I am freezing. Oh yeah. So this will get us back to our original base at least. Wow, all the resource stuff respawned again. Nice. So we come up over here and we should get see, we're slowly coming up on it. You'll be able to see the big build we've been working on. How you doing? You are a little touchy. Ow. Ouch. Thank you. I want that pistol. What do we have that we can get rid of? You know what? I'm gonna scrap that. I want the pistol for the parts. Looking forward to getting the NOS at it. Nice. Yeah, like I said, I took a look at that game. It was like 30 seconds. Like, nah, nope, not going to do it. So this is the building that we are currently working on. As you can see, we've got a couple of floors done in there. What are we up to? 4 floors that are basically ready to go. We're working on the 5th floor of the build now. So it's starting to come together. You know what? I'm going to stop in here and see. Did you guys respawn? No. Okay. I'm going to be mad if my bag despawned or broke. Oh, I'm going to be mad. Because I'm not seeing it up on the little indicator up here anymore. Because see? I'm not seeing my bag. What are you doing? Down she goes. Oh, they destroyed my bag. I can't believe they destroyed my bag. I'm gonna have to look at the playback and see what I lost. That is really annoying, because I know I lost my rifle. Okay, you need to. There we go. How many of you guys are here? Holy crap. So, not only have they been sitting here beating on my base for a while? Yeah, we're just gonna start zombie raging here. I am not playing around with you all anymore. Come here. Look, it's a feral. It's always great when you get the regular zombies that go feral. Man, they have destroyed this place. Get out of there. Alright. I'm not sure, Shades. I was standing on my bike. A screamer spawned. The screamer did the yell. Had some zombies start spawning. And I died with no actual indication of what killed me. Oh, look. Something to take rage out on. Come here. Oh, come on. Any more? Whoop. Sounds like someone inside, too. Oh, come on. Sheesh. Oh, look at them all. Oh, come on. That was bullcrap. That was a cop. If we're bleeding, make sure there's no sleepers up here. And this is why I want to relocate my my current building. Is because we have a zombie freeway over here. Oh, come on. I like how that shot went through his face and killed the guy behind him. Okay, where's that Papa Smurf at? Come here. We do not like line cutters. Everybody has to wait their turn. That includes you. Anything good? Oh, thank you. We'll take that. Come here. Oh, you're an irradiated cop. Well, that's not very nice. Let's see if we can deal with this guy. I hate the fact you can't shoot through the metal rails anymore. There we go. Shut up. You are making too much noise, huh? There we go. Anything good? Not too bad, actually. Let's wear that. Normally I wouldn't do that. I would normally have used that to repair the one that I am now wearing. That's okay. Use that to drink. Okay. We'll come back and finish cleaning all that up later. Anything good? Man. That was a crazy number of zombies. All right. Yeah, I know you get 20 minutes in the chunk. That's one of the things I think was a bad design choice on Mad Mole's part. Come on. Tin hat, yeah. Alright, so let's go ahead and drop. Do we have any food on us? No. We have cooking supplies, though. No, no. Oh, son of a. Close enough. Alright. Drop that off. No, we're just going to drop that. Actually, you know what? Dropbox time. There we go. Alright, so what do we got for... You're supposed to be ammo. Right? Okay, so... Yeah, we don't have any of our... Ah, crap. Alright. So we're gonna swap you guys out for it now. We'll let you guys deal with it. Alright. So you coming with, you coming with. Okay. You come with, because we're going to go put you away. I forget. Do I have anything else over here? No. Okay. We'll put the ammo away, or ammo stuff away, I should say. Come on. There we go. Oh, I do need to be picking up paper. Crap. I'll drop this stuff off. That should be the end of the inventory management stuff, I think, for the most part. You are lead? Yes, you are lead. Okay. Yeah, I know, right? Oh, not much, Red. I came back and got zombie swarmed. So, and my bag despawned before I could get back in time, so. Okay, so let me go ahead and grab that. So we're going to use that. We're going to, let me see. Let's go check our bike. It happens. It's frustrating. I'll make a list of the stuff that I lost later. I know I lost my sniper rifle. I lost... I didn't lose my pickaxe. Didn't lose the auger. But I did lose... So I lost my shovel. My club, which I'm remaking right now, my sniper, my compound bow. My compound bow is probably the biggest thing that I'm going to be mad about. All Okay, so she's dead. He was just outside the range of the pistol. Now, I thought I had an extra sniper. Go ahead and close that for a second. I could swear I had another sniper rifle in over here. Did I leave it over at the other base? And I have no clue why we're spawning so many zombies over here. Because we haven't been doing anything over here to spawn zombies. Yeah, see, no sniper there. Did I put my sniper somewhere else? Alright, so what do we have? How many of the sniper parts do we have? Do we have any parts? Pistol, shotgun, this. I guess we can use the hunting rifle for now. Hey, no worries, Red. Hope you have a great night. Thanks for stopping in. Sounds like they're inside the place again. And this is why I was saying I want to open up the walls in there. Because if I open up the walls, I don't have to worry about them digging through things, because they'll path through the first passageway that they can. Where am I being hunted? I can't tell if that hit or not. Alright, so I'm guessing she's dead. Alright, let's go. Come on, down the ladder. Thank you. I'll take the food, thank you. I really hate the fact that you can't kill them by running them over anymore. All right. Hello, miss. Goodbye, miss. Ah, I was hoping to get two for one, but one down. Fire just a hair too soon. All right. Anything good? No, of course not. All right. So we're gonna go head back over to the new the little crafting base here. Get things set up for this evening. Trying to figure out, I'm gonna definitely have to go back, take a look, see what everything that I lost. Alright, so I'm gonna go ahead and call this one here. I wanna thank you all for stopping in. Hopefully you enjoyed it. I had a lot of fun hanging out with you all today. We will be back here for more 7 Days to Die on Friday evening at 5 p.m. We will be doing Space Engineers tomorrow and Thursday. So if you're interested in open world sandbox games, we're gonna have a lot of them. If you haven't done so already, you might also want to follow me over on YouTube, because I do release pre-recorded stuff over on that side of the house. But hopefully you enjoyed it. So thank you all for stopping in. Let me see, before you all take off, let's see if we can find somebody who's doing a little bit of 7 Days to Die here today. Because we'll do a little bit of a raid. If there's anyone out there, let's see who we got. Oh, CB the Great's running. Looks like he's the only one running right now. That's what I get for reopening the Twitch stream here. So let us go pay a visit to CB the Great. We are going to go hit him up. Let him know that you are coming over for me by telling him he has just been pounced on the panda. Let him know that you love him. If you haven't seen him, CB the Great actually does a lot of really good 7 Days to Die content. Really good guy. So definitely pay him a visit. And we will see you in the next one. As always, folks, take care and be safe out there, everybody.
What is the right way to say this? You know what? No, I'm not going to creative that. How about that? I was going to creative that. I'm not going to do it. I'm not going to do it. I was. I mean, I already was flying a little bit there, but I mean, come on. All right. Let's fix this. Thank you for the host, man. Appreciate it. How was the stream? How was it going? Tell me stuff and things. Textbook, please. Thank you for the follow. Appreciate it. Welcome to C-Block, guys. We have crossed over 5K. White Wedding Song seems official now. Seems appropriate. You know what I mean? Nice White Wedding Song. Okay. Let's figure this out. First death in the playthrough? Nice. What are your settings like? You don't mind me asking. Shit, your first death. You must not do much in that playthrough, Haladmer. Like, building or anything, right? Do you have other people build? Okay, that's pretty insane. It's a pretty insane amount of... You didn't actually donate it, man. And to be completely honest, number one, I have a special command for people like you, SR. Number one, which I'm sure somebody will trigger in a second. Number two, dude, really? Like, I feel bad that when people like this cuck in here tries to pull this shit in chat, I feel bad, because there's probably been a handful of people that's worked on. So we're gonna see you out the door in a second, man. If you think that's funny, it's not. I don't know if your wiener is incredibly small. I don't know if penis envy is typically what